With our special guest of the day, Bill Dromo, an outdoorsman, a hunter, a professional wrestler, after this commercial message.
Look, there's no question about the fact that he is the Georgia heavyweight champion.
I'm right in the middle of this whole thing. Everybody is looking for Austin Idol. Right now, I'm currently the Georgia heavyweight champion. I was ripped off for the national television heavyweight champion of this big dummy. Can you believe that big dummy Raschke honestly believes that title belongs to him when he knows full well that he would have never beaten that man if it wouldn't have been for me? That's my title and will remain my title when it comes out of limbo, whatever the case may be.
I assume that you are completely recovered from your, quote, slight concussion.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am recovered. You know, when you're in top shape like I am, you're constantly training, you're constantly in the top physical peak of condition, you have those recuperative powers that are beyond the average man. And we're not dealing with the average man here. This is professional wrestling. We don't wear helmets. We don't wear knee pads. We don't wear thigh pads. This is an individual sport. We don't need 9 other people. We don't need 10 other people. We do it all alone. We do it all by ourselves. And wrestling number 2, I do everything I want to do by myself. I don't have a manager to take care of my financial affairs or any kind of business affairs. I'm truly an island unto myself. And tonight, in the Marietta Cobb County Civic Center Wrestling 2, you are going to feel the wrath of Austin Idol. You know, he is going around and he's calling himself the champ of champions. Now, that may very well be true right now, but don't forget, Wrestling 2, I am the man who beats you right in the middle of the ring to take this belt off your waist. I am your master, Wrestling 2, and don't forget it tonight.
In the world, as far as I'm concerned, and you've already defended that title.
Well, you know, Gordon, it's number 1 in the world without even saying. You know, all due respect to all champions. They carry belts, they hold belts. They're all champions in their own rights. But I am the number 1, whether you like it or not. I am the champion of all champions. And I have a cup to prove it. You know, a lot of people are up here very high because they feel that it should belong to them. But I got it. And I got it not just because I'm a great wrestler, not just because I like a lot of people like me, because I deserve it. I fought for that title and I got it. And it's mine. I'm the champion of champions. And let me tell you something right now, Austin Idol. Tonight in Marietta, pal, you say that you do your thing on your own? Well, where do you come from? You say that you took that belt from me all by yourself? Well, a lot of people know different. It took 3 of you to put me down. 3 of you to put me down! Well, let me tell you something, Austin Idol. I am the champion of...
It's not wrestling, Ernie Ladd. In fact, it happened here in the WTBS TV auditorium. This program is seen on Channel 17 Atlanta. It's seen on Channel 38 in Columbus, Channel 26 in Augusta, and on this giant cable from Channel 17 in 8 million cable homes. We get great response to it. The over 200,000 written responses about Wrestling 2 is living proof of that. But things happen sometime where only the man himself involved can settle the issue. What happened to Chief J. Strongbow is that he set out to wrestle one man, and after the match, got into a fracas with Ernie Ladd. Well, in case you missed the incident, we'll just recall it for you by letting you see it as it occurred. Here then is Chief J. Strongbow and the Ernie Ladd incident.
Strongbow suddenly fires back. Strongbow catches him with another chop. High knee lift that puts Buckstar to the canvas. Chief J. Strongbow, and there you see an irate Ernie Ladd, but Chief J. Strongbow. moving very effectively in double chop to the throat. Strongbow chopped down across the throat once again. A count of three. A count of three. Well, we see the genius of Ernie Ladd. Didn't accomplish much there. Wait a second. Ernie Ladd closing in. And it is Strongbow catching Ladd. Strongbow catches him again. Strongbow goes after him with his briefcase now. Ernie Ladd whipped off the ropes, caught by Strongbow. Ladd in trouble. And Chief J. Strongbow has gone wild. There comes Ladd again. Chief J. Strongbow having defeated Buckstar. Now is Ernie Ladd. And his dress closed. And he's got the sleeper hold. Chief J. Strongbow's got the sleeper hold on Ernie the Cat Ladd. 6 feet, 9 inches tall. 320 pounds, but Chief J. Strongbow has him after being Pearl Harbored by Ernie Ladd. Chief J. Strongbow bearing down with that sleeper hold. And don't you know there's got to be tremendous pressure there to get a man like Ernie the Cat Ladd, 6'9", 320 pounds, and he's going to Knoxville. He has gone to Knoxville. Ernie Ladd is out. Chief J. Strongbow has just wiped out Ernie Ladd, and the referee telling him, well, this isn't a match. It isn't a match, but this is very dangerous. It is very, very important that he do wake up Ernie Ladd. That is a critical situation. The longer he remains unconscious, the more possibility there is of permanent injury. I don't blame Jay Strongbow. He's obviously extremely mad. Ladd refused to wrestle him. And now he refused to wrestle him, and Pearl harbored him. But Jay Strongbow, it is his responsibility to awaken him. He is going to have to awaken that man. That is a responsibility. Ladd still out. Strongbow in behind him. A sharp blow back of the heart. And apparently it did not waken him. Apparently he's been out. He's been out long enough that we have some... he started to raise up. And now Chief J. Strongbow, he has not, apparently has not revived him. I saw Ladd move upward just momentarily, but apparently the referee is not at all pleased with this situation. And he's insisting that he wake him up again. No, sir. It did not, and the referee is still arguing with Chief J. Strongbow, but it has not. Oh, wait a minute. Ladd had moved. Apparently still, wait a second, Ernie Ladd catching J. Strongbow. Catches Jay Strongbow coming in. Ernie Ladd hurling the referee to one side. Ernie Ladd now. Jay crushing Jay Strongbow. Strongbow fighting away. Another referee moves in there. Ernie Ladd lifts him up outside the ring. He has cleared the ring. Ernie Ladd is... Wait a minute. Ernie Ladd has grabbed the headdress and is tearing that headdress to shreds. Ernie Ladd. Humiliation for Chief J. Strongbow. Ernie Ladd completely destroying that Indian headdress, completely humiliating him now, slapping him openly across the face. Strongbow trying desperately to fight his way back. He's tied up in those ropes. And again, Ernie Ladd clearing the ring. And we've got to do something here. We've got to do something. Wait a second. Everybody in there, we've got, all right, we've got the situation squared away, and we'll be...